Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Earthquakes in diverse places have been occurring a lot lately. Another one, a magnitude 2.6, off the coast of Hermosa Beach, California. 100 people reported feeling this earthquake, but I think it is significant. It may have occurred along the Compton Blind Thrust Fault. This fault zone is capable of creating a magnitude 7 or greater earthquake. The reason it is called a blind thrust fault is that there is no surface indication that it exists there. In the last 14,000 years, it has had 6 major earthquakes between magnitude 7 and 7.4 earthquakes. Until recently, they considered it an inactive fault zone. If there is a large earthquake along this fault zone, it could trigger landslides, tsunamis, earthquakes along other fault zones. An example very close to this 2.6 is the Redondo Canyon fault zone that is capable of creating a huge tsunami. Let me move this down a little bit so you can read this. Redondo Canyon collapsed. The canyon walls could flood. Low-lying areas, inundating zones, might include Marina del Rey and the shores of Santa Monica and the South Bay Beach cities. This, too, is a folding fault, meaning it's not a thrust fault going side by side, but caused by folding. I found a document about the Compton fault. You can see here how it goes underneath Los Angeles. The Compton Fault extends northwest to southeast for about 40 kilometers beneath the western edge of the Los Angeles metropolitan region. One area of study was along Stanford Avenue in south central Los Angeles, 10 kilometers south of downtown high-rise district. Deep penetration petroleum industry seismic reflection profiles provide an exceptional clear image of the folding above the Compton thrust ramp beneath the site. The borehole testing showed that there was 6 events along Stanford Avenue of earthquakes of magnitude 7 and 7.4 or greater in the last 14,000 years. Because of the folding, the smallest uplift that was detected, the smallest uplift, which would be 5 feet 7 inches, that was the smallest uplift they had during those 6 earthquakes. There was 2 other events, what they call 5 and 6, and that had an uplift of over 8 feet. It also says that thus all growth of the Compton Los Alamos fold probably occurred in large magnitude events. As a point of comparison, the 1994 Northridge 6.7 earthquake, which ruptured a similar type of fault, but was much smaller than the events documented here on the Compton ramp, caused widespread damage and remains one of the costliest natural disasters in U.S. history. Moreover, blind thrust earthquakes of the type forecast on the Compton thrust that occurred directly beneath the metropolitan regions have been shown to produce very large ground motions that pose particular concerns to high-rise buildings. I couldn't find any earthquakes listed for this fault zone. It's been a very long time. But I did find that the fault line more likely goes directly under this one bridge. Let me try and get it where I can get the name here. That would be the Vincent Thomas Bridge. So let's take a look where Sanford Avenue that is, where they did this study, and the fault line extends through, the folding extends through. All right, let me bring it out. Right there. So when I found this earthquake in a place where we normally don't have earthquakes, and I couldn't find record of any earthquakes along the Compton Blind Thrust Fault, and you have a 20% chance that any earthquake could be a foreshock for something much larger. They used to say within a week, but they now know that it could happen within a year. Just another reason why you guys need to be prepared for a major earthquake. Yeah, can you imagine 8 feet of uplift and you're in a high-rise building or in the shadow of a high-rise building? Do you have a bug-out kit? Do you have a plan what to do? 8 feet of uplift, you would have ruptured water lines. You would have ruptured gas lines. Roads would be impassable. There is no way emergency services could come to your rescue. Phone service would be down. Cell phone towers would be down. You'd be lucky if they were still working that you could even get text messaging out. So, what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.